Hello, welcome again. We are solving some conventional questions of power plant. The topic is impulse turbine. Question number 73 from Civil Service Main 2018 is the data pertaining to an impulse turbine are as follows. Blade speed 300 meter per second, isentropic enthalpy drop in nozzle 450 kilojoule per kg, nozzle efficiency 0.9, nozzle angle 20 degree, blade velocity coefficient 0.85, blade exit angle 25 degree. Sketch the velocity diagram and calculate for the mass flow rate of 1 kg per second the following. 1. The inlet angle of moving blade. 2. The axial thrust. 3. Driving force on the wheel. 4. The diagram power. 5. The energy lost in the blade due to friction. So here it is given that the enthalpy drop in nozzle is isentropic enthalpy drop is given, that is 450 kilojoules per kilogram, and isentropic efficiency is 0.9, so actual enthalpy drop is 405 kilojoules per kilogram, and velocity at the axial of nozzle is velocity at the axial of nozzle can be found by balancing energy. So this is the enthalpy drop, okay, and velocity at the inlet of the nozzle is assumed 0. And velocity at the exit of the nozzle is V or V1. Okay. So this is kinetic energy, change in kinetic energy, because initial velocity is 0, so change in kinetic energy is this, and change in or drop in enthalpy is this. So equating change in kinetic energy to enthalpy drop, we can find out V is your 900%, and that is the velocity at the inlet of the turbine. Velocity at the exit of nozzle is same as that of velocity at the inlet of turbine. So blade velocity is given as 400 meter per second. Sorry, 300 meter per second. Blade velocity is given as, blade speed is given as 300 meter per second. So U is 300 meter per second. And nozzle angle is given as 20 degrees. So now we'll draw the velocity diagram. So this is your V1 or V, nozzle at that velocity at the exit of nozzle or velocity at the inlet of turbine V1, and this is the bulb component VW1, and this is the flow component, and this is blade velocity, this is nozzle angle, this is blade angle. Okay. So from V1 we can find out VW1. So VW1 is V1 cos alpha, alpha is given, that is 20 degrees, so V1 is 900, so it is 845.72 meter per second, and U is 300 meter per second, so VW1 minus U is, this is VW1 and this is U, and this is VW1 minus U is your 545.72 meter per second. So this is the horizontal relative velocity component, and vertical component is Vf1, so this is V1 sin alpha 1, sin alpha, so 900 sin 20, so this is 307.81. So relative velocity component is V1 minus U whole square plus Vf1 square, so that is root, so that is 540.72 plus square plus 307.8 square, so this is 626.55 meter per second, and the blade angle is your Vf1 minus Vf1 divided by Vw1 by minus U, this tangent of this is perpendicular, this is your base, and this is tangent of this, so tangent beta 1 is Vf1 divided by Vw1 minus U, so beta 1 number is 29.425, and blade velocity coefficient is given, so Vr2 by Vr1 is 0.85. Blade velocity coefficient is the change in relative velocity within the blade. So VR1 is 626.55, so VR2 will be 532.567. Now drawing outlet velocity diagram, so this is your outlet velocity diagram, this is your V2, absolute velocity at outlet, this is VR2, relative velocity at outlet, this is the exit angle with the absolute velocity, this is exit blade angle, this is bulb component, this is U, and this is VW plus below to consume, and this is the horizontal electricity component, and this is the vertical electricity component. So horizontal velocity and beta 2 is given as 25 degrees, and VR2 we have found out. So VR2 cos beta 2 will be your this. VR2 cos beta 2 will be VW2 plus U. So VW2 comes, VW2 plus U is this quantity, and U is 300 at impulse. In impulse domain, inlet and outlet blade velocity is same. So VW2 is 182.67 meter per second. Okay, so now VF2, VF2 is VR2 sin beta 2. So VR2 is 532.56 sin 25, so that is 225.069 meter per second. Okay, so this is VF2. So now we have found all the things necessary for our calculation. Now first question was inlet angle of the moving wave, that we have found out, that is 29.42. Second, axial thrust. Axial thrust is, because mass is one unit, so we will find out the axial thrust per unit mass per person. So that is VF1 minus VF2. So VF1 is 307.81 and VF2 is 225.069, so that is 82.7491. And driving force, which is responsible for power also, that is VW1 direction is this direction, V1 is this way, and VW2 direction is this direction. So change in bulk component multiplied by mass will be, mass per second will be your driving force. So that is mass is 1 kg per second, so it comes as 1028.39. And diagram power, driving force into velocity of turbine, speed of turbine, that is 308.517 kilowatt. And energy loss due in blade due to friction, 1/2 VR1 square minus VR2 square. So that is 54.470.